Good morning, Hampton Academy Sharks.
I'm Xavier.
And I'm Anthony. Today is Friday, October 7th, 2022.
Today is a B-Day.
This week, we are featuring segments on the recent 6th grade Geography Day, a segment on charity event that a couple students participated in, and a student in the Spotlight segment, and segments on boys and girls soccer.
The winners of this summer reading raffle are
Squishmallow, Allie Hamlin,
Barnes & Noble gift card, Renee Mama,
Susie Sweets gift cards, Ethan Roy and Lucy Grody.
Congratulations. Please visit the library to pick up your prize.
Lunch will be stuffed crust pizza, garden salad, fresh fruit, and milk. That lunch sounds yummy, yummy.
The Pat Peak Ski Club informational meeting has been rescheduled to next Wednesday, October 12th at 6 p.m.
A Pat Peak representative will be here to answer all questions.
Gibson visited another class this week. Can you guess where he is?
If you guess Ms. Koffel's Spanish class, you are right. Also, did you know Gibson has a mini-me?
He lives with 6th grade Cole.
There is no school on Monday in honor of Columbus Day.
Here at the library hours, the library is open before school on Tuesday and Thursday starting at 7:20. Please sign in and pick up a pass in the student lobby before coming up.
The library makerspace will be open to students on Tuesday after school from 2:25 to 3:25 starting on Tuesday, October 18th. Please email or see Ms. Saunders if you are interested in coming.
Good morning, Hampton Academy Sharks. I'm here with two returning Shark News members, Elizabeth and Emma. Good morning. Elizabeth, what is your favorite class over at the high school?
My favorite class is Global Perspectives Honors.
And Emma, how do you think high school is going so far this year?
Honestly, it's amazing. High school, they make it sound like it's terrifying and like the seniors are going to kill you, but they don't, and it's actually very fun.
Thank you both for being on Shark News, and welcome back.
Good morning, Hampton Academy Sharks. I'm here with a representative from the Hampton Historical Society, Ms. McCoy. Ms. McCoy is also a paraprofessional at Marston School. Good morning, Ms. McCoy.
Good morning, Noah.
I understand that coming up soon, the Hampton Historical Society is representing a fall festival. Can you tell us where the festival is and if there are a rain date?
Sure. We'll be hosting the Hampton Historical Society's second annual fall festival on the field next to the Tuck Museum on October 9th from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. If it does rain, we do have a rain date of October 10th from 11 to 3 also.
Okay. What kinds of things will be featured at the fall festival?
So we're going to have a lot of really fun stuff. We're excited to welcome back some amazing aerial acrobatic performances. We will also have a food truck, the Big Bad. We will have an awesome children's entertainment duo, Vegetable Circus, and we'll have a bunch of local organizations working with us, like the Mounted Police, to put on some really fun booths and activities.
Thank you, Ms. McCoy, for visiting Shark News to tell us about the Fall Festival. I'm sure a lot of people will attend the festival.
Thank you.
Last Friday, September 30th, 6th graders at Hampton Academy celebrated the school's first ever Geography Day. After spending the first weeks of school learning map skills and world geography, they celebrated their hard work and new knowledge with a fun day in which they packed their passports and suitcases and traveled the world.
Each sixth grade teacher turned their classroom into a different continent or the oceans, and students traveled throughout the rooms doing different activities to explore and celebrate each continent. Leah had the chance to speak with some of the students about the day, and we have some pictures too.
Take a look.
Good morning, Hampton Academy Sharks. I'm here with
Hannah
and Charlie.
Today is Geography Day. Charlie, can you please tell us what Geography Day is about?
So you go around in all the sixth grade rooms, and each room has their own continent, and there's one room with an ocean, and they just teach you about it and talk about it, and that's about it.
And Hannah, what's your favorite part about Geography Day
so far? My favorite part is doing all the activities.
Thanks for being on Shark News.
Thanks.
Hello again. This time I'm here with
Sophia Dahl
and Cole Buckley.
And Sophia, what was your favorite part about Geography Day today?
Probably the activities. My favorite continent was probably Australia, and probably my favorite activity in Australia is probably cross the river.
Nice. And Cole, what was your favorite activity and continent?
I like zebra, cross my savannah. It was really good.
Nice. Thank you guys for being on Shark News. Hi, I'm here with
Audrey.
Deacon.
And so, Audrey, what's your favorite activity you've done so far?
I really like all of them.
Nice. And Deacon, what's your favorite craft you've done so far?
I have to say the koala.
Okay, thank you guys for being on Shark News.
Thank you.
Good morning, Hampton Academy Sharks. I'm here with this week's student in the spotlight, Willow Bick. Good morning, Willow.
Good morning.
I understand that you're an artist. How long do you think you've been drawing?
I think I've been drawing ever since I could really pick up a pencil, but I've been animating for like 2 or 3 years now.
And how did you learn how to do those things?
It's mainly self-taught. I've watched like a few tutorials here and there, but a lot of it's just trial and error.
And do you have a favorite medium of artwork?
Well, usually I work digital, which like is on my phone, but sometimes I use pencil and paper.
That's pretty cool. We're gonna check out some of your work now. That's some pretty cool artwork. Thank you for being on Shark News.
You're welcome.
This week, Jack had a chance to speak with some of the Hampton Academy soccer players.
The boys' team has 5 wins, and the girls' team has 3 wins, 1 tie, and 1 loss.
Take a look at these interviews and some pictures and videos from this week's game.
Good morning, Hampton Academy Sharks. I'm here with
Julia,
Molly,
Ari,
and Chloe,
who are members of the girls' soccer team. Julia, what do you think some of the team's strengths are this year?
I think that we're really good at passing and communicating.
Molly, what do you think are some of the things the team can work on?
I think we can work on spreading the field and not passing to the middle on defense.
Ari, what is your favorite part about soccer?
The funness of a team.
Anything else or just that?
Just that.
And Chloe, what is also your favorite part of soccer?
My favorite part of soccer is getting to know some of the new girls I have never met before.
Thank you all for being on Shark News. Good morning, Hampton Academy Sharks. I'm here with
Nathan,
Brody,
and David,
who are all members of the boys' soccer team. Nathan, what's your record this year?
We are undefeated, and we have 0 losses and 0 ties.
And what strengths do you think brought you to that good record?
I think some of our strengths are switching the field. We also talk really well with each other, and we keep the ball well.
Brody, what are some things you'd like to improve on this year?
I think our communication's key, and we need to improve on, and I think we need to spread out more.
Thank you. And David, what is your favorite part about playing soccer?
I like traveling on the bus and just being with my friends and playing soccer.
Thank you all so much for being on Shark News.
Thank you. Thank you.
Recently, 2 Hampton Academy students donated their time and energy to a charity that took place in Exeter.
We're proud of the fact that they took the time to be involved in good in this good cause.
Cooper had a chance to speak with them about it.
Take a look.
I'm here with 2 eighth graders, Emma and Lucio. They recently participated in a charity event. Can you tell me about that, Emma?
The fundraiser was for children who need to stay warm during the winter.
We raised the money by going out, dresses, ducks, and we sell tickets.
The tickets were for a raffle, and the winner would usually win $1,000, and the rest of the money would go to the charity.
So we understand there was a race involved with this. Could you explain that a little bit? And how long was the race?
Well, the race was like 2 minutes.
And the race was with people dressed as ducks.
All right, Emma, Lucio, thank you for being on Shark News.
And now for the weather. Today we will have partly cloudy skies. There will be a slight chance of a rain shower. High temperature today will be 73 degrees. Saturday we will have sun and a few passing clouds. It will be much cooler. The high temperature will be 57 degrees. On Sunday, except for a few afternoon clouds, it'll be mainly sunny with high temperature 61 degrees. On Monday, our day off, it will be partly cloudy and 59 degrees.
This week, we had one weather photo. It was sent in by Hazel Brisner. It is titled, Sun Coming Up Over the Trees. Thanks, Hazel, for sending that photo. And remember, you can send your Shark News weather photos into sharknews@su90.org.
And remember to remain sunny side up.
Celebrating their birthdays on Friday are Muhammad, O'Connor, Reagan, Paige, and Sienna Rush.
Celebrating on Sunday is Emma Clifford. Happy birthday, Mohammed, Reagan, Sienna, and Emma.
Our fact of the day is something for you to guess.
According to candystore.com, what is the most popular candy in the USA?
Today, the first Friday of October, is World Smile Day.
This holiday was created by a commercial artist named Harvey Ball. This day came about as a response to his creation of the smiley face.
Harvey worried that the symbol wouldn't always have the impact he intended. So he created this World Smile Day.
These little yellow faces are more than just a symbol. They're a statement about the power of smiling.
Our thought of the day comes from Albert Einstein, who was a German-born scientist who specialized in physics.
He was widely acknowledged to be one of the greatest and most influential physicists of all time. He said, "If you can't explain it simply, you don't understand it well enough." Albert Einstein.
Hey, Liam.
Hey, what?
Why did the gum cross the road?
I don't know why.
Because it was stuck to the chicken's foot.
Our answer to the fact of the day is this.
Candystore.com or Candy Store has been delivering and distributing bulk orders of candy across the country since 2007.
Using their sales data since then for the time period before Halloween, they determined which candy was the most popular, with the winner being
Reese's Cups.
Before you speak, text, chat, or post, ask yourself,
is it kind?
Is it true?
And is it necessary?
And remember the Academy way.
Manage yourself.
Act responsibly.
And respect yourself and others.
Go out there and make it a great day.
Woo!